This is Ben Lang-Henricks with a mini lesson called Quick Mask, which I show two easy ways to use the Quick Mask in Gimp 2.8. The way the Quick Mask works is a little like a layer mask, except easier. Select something. In this case, I'm going to select around the doorway. Then you click on the Quick Mask icon, which is fairly hidden. So I'm going to show you where that is. I've got a selection, and when I click on it, right down in that lower left-hand corner, it turns everything that's not selected red, but you can still see through it. It's like a layer mask in that you can go in and you can paint in and out features using black and white, just like a layer mask, except that you actually see the features behind it, so it's a little bit easier. And it's a very quick way of forming a selection. Anything that's not red will be selected. So I'm going to take a little bit away from the selection right now by painting in black, which shows as red. When I'm finished with this, I click the Quick Mask again, and I have a selection. But one advantage that you have over regular layer mask is now I can just use that selection. I'm actually going to invert the selection because I want everything outside the doorway. And I can do anything I want with that. I don't have to just show through something below. So I'm going to turn it into a cartoon look like this, just so you can see that I've done something to the rest of the picture. And then I've got my image. That's how easy it is to use Quick Mask to take a certain selection and do things to it. Another way to do it is to use Quick Mask for kind of a vignette or border around something. So I'm going to take this image and make an oval around it. Then I'm going to click on the Quick Mask again, and you'll see the selection right around her. But now I'm going to actually play with the selection, or with the red, by putting some waves in there. And the waves will be on just the red part. You can see them a little bit. I'm going to click the Quick Mask again. And now that selection is inside, I'm going to invert it again. And now I'm going to paste white out there where the selection is. And what you'll see is we're going to get a nice border area. Remove the selection so you can see it. And just makes for a very nice border around her. Anyway, these are a couple quick ways you can use Quick Mask. Please join us again for more mini lessons at minilessons.info.